in this part and the next parts, we will implement a gridded surface, subsurface, hydrologic analysis, GSSHA, in WMS, using the file with the title GSSHA that prepared in advance in the following path. As we see, this file titled GSSHA, which contains shapefile map of soil type and land cover and various information and data that needed to implement GSSHA in WMS, whereas the method of obtaining and preparing shapefile maps for the soil type and land cover and various information and data needed to implement GSSHA in WMS have been explained in the previous videos, where we will, in this part and the next parts, implement GSSHA in WMS for the study area, which is the Wadi and Mur Basin, where we will implement GSSHA in WMS on a small part of the valley, because the implementation of GSSHA in WMS over the entire basin takes very long time and consumes a large amount of memory from the hard drive. Here are the steps to implement GSSHA in WMS. In the beginning, we create a file for the project entitled GSSHA project part of Wadi Al-Mur. In the following path, computer partition F, we create this file entitled GSSHA project part of Wadi Al-Mur in partition F, because it contains a large amount of memory that's sufficient to implement GSSHA in WMS. Then we put in the project file this daily weather data from the global weather data for SWAT website, and the rainfall data in millimeter per hour in this file. The method of obtaining hourly and daily weather data are shown in the videos of the weather data category. We also put a dam map for the study area entitled Wadi Al-Mur and file under the title results for purpose of implementation of the program. Before starting the implementation of GSSHA in WMS, we open the help files in the implementation process. which are found here in the file entitled GSSHA. And in this path, we open this file, and inside it we open a PDF file entitled 47 GSSHA-Modeling-Wizard. We also open a PDF file entitled 49 GSSHA-Application-Precipitation. And we also open the Word file titled GSSHA in the following path. As we see, where we open a Word file titled GSSHA, then we open the WMS program. And we continue with the implementation, where we go to the hydrologic modeling wizard and click on it with left click on it. The first window appears titled a project file name, and in it we specify the location of the project file, where we click on the file icon. Then we go to the following path: computer, partition F, GSSHA project, part of Wadi Al-Murr. Results. Then we type the saved address, which is GSSHA. Then we click on save. Then we click on save again. Then it saves in this path. Then in this path, as we see. Then we click next. We come to define a project bounds. Then we go to the project projection. Then we click on define. And we choose a global projection. Then we click on set a projection. And we select projection UTM zone 38 and datum WGS 84. And then we press OK. Then OK. Then we click on next. And a window entitled Watershed Data appears. And we go to the Select Data Source. And click on Open File. And we go to the project file entitled GSSHA Project, part of Wadi Al-Murr. in which we choose the map titled Wadi Al Murdim. Then we press open, then OK. The dam map of study area opens, and here there are options, namely use web surfaces and use a catalog file, which are used to obtain information about the study area from the internet. Then we click next. Then we choose write to pass file to a temp directory, and we define compute subbasin areas in square kilometers and compute distance in meter, and in mine flow accumulation threshold we choose number 10. Then we click on compute to pass. The calculation starts, and then we click on close. The flow lines are added to the dam map of the study area. Then we click next. The window title changes to choose outlet location, and in it we choose a create outlet point. Where we define the outlet for the basin of the study area, which is Wadi Al Mur, and since it will be implemented here on a part of Wadi Al Mur, we define the outlet for the part of Wadi Al Mur where we make a left click on the flow line at this point. Then we click next. The window title changes to Delineate Watershed. Then we click on Delineate Watershed. The boundaries of study area are determined for a part of Wadi Al Mur with the area of 142.19 kilometer square.